Hello there, Ray here, and the latest Snapchat 18W16A is out. And with it, they are wrapping up the aquatic update, so they are concentrating on a whole bunch of bug fixes, which I will all go over. They now added that coral fans are now naturally generated a part of the coral reefs. They also fixed the transition between different types of ocean types so it's more smoother. As you can see here, we got a nice warm ocean, and we even got a coral reef here, and it goes pretty well with the islands around it. So it's not like an abrupt change from like a cold biome to a really warm ocean. And you can see with the coral reef here, it's not like super large like the ones we've seen in the past. It's more scattered out. Now you will have to use a silk touch to get the actual colored coral. If you use a normal pick, it turns out that you'll just get the dead coral, but you will still get that variation of it. Now you can still acquire the coral plants just by punching them. Same goes for the fan variations. They changed some of the block and name tags that come with coral. So we look at the names of them. You see this one's called Bubble Coral Block and this one's called Dead Bubble Coral Block. And if we look at it with our F3 up in the top right hand corner, we can see that this is a Minecraft Bubble Coral Block. And underneath this is Minecraft Coral Block. And underneath that it says Minecraft Live Coral Block. So if we look and we switch between the different variations, over here it just says dead. And this one now it says it is a dead variation of it. So they just did some slight changes there. They now have it so that drowns can generate with the underwater rune structures. So I came across the structure and generated it while being in spectre mode. So there's no way for these mobs to naturally spawn here, and they are part of the structure. Let's go ahead and see if these have special NBT tags. So I pulled the data off of this drown. This is all the NBT that this drown has by using this command here. You can see that he has a persistent required of 1B. This means that he cannot despawn. These are very unique mobs in that they are able to always be in your world and never despawn, even without a name tag. So you also can see some other tags that are unique to drown, such as in water time, where you're trying to convert a zombie over into a drown, as well as the drown conversion time, how long it's going to take him to turn into a drown. Having a persistence required 1B is the same as the witches that naturally generate with a witch hut, and same goes for like the zombie villager that you find inside of an igloo. It seems with this structure that they may have not hidden the chest quite well enough. They changed the liquids now so that there is a distinguish between scheduling of liquid ticks as well as block ticks. You can see that the water is way more consistent when it moves outwards, and even when you like remove it, you can see it easily all gets removed at the same time. You also notice that you can place water on top of plants instead of placing it inside of the plant. Now this may not seem like a big deal that you can place water on top of grasses, but this actually was a big thing that I advocated for a long time trying to get this bug fixed, and they kept saying it was work as intended, but pretty much this allows you to be able to place water on top of open fence gates, which was impossible before, as well as being able to place water on top of cobwebs and a bunch of other blocks. I'll put the full bug report down in the description. I also noticed that the tall grass has a full collision box for both top and bottom, where the grass itself has a smaller one. Now the changes so that when water is going to make a source block, such in this situation, let's say there is a block here, and when I remove this block, then these two water sources are going to come over here. And normally they would first come as a flowing water, then they turn into a water source, but if you see, as soon as I remove this block here, it will immediately turn into a water source. This means you can make extremely fast water sources if you wanted to make like automatic system that would refill your buckets. Now the changes that they made to the water ticking is very nice because it makes it extremely consistent the way cobble generators can be. So I'll break these two blocks. Even though I broke this one a little bit later, you see that they both generate at the exact same time. This is really nice because it can make farms like such as cobble farms being extremely predictable. So you don't have to try to predict when the water is going to move. And here you know exactly when these stones are going to come into play, so you can exactly push them into your machine. Now they said they also made blue ice less slippery, so I'm guessing they fixed it so that boats don't accelerate like almost seemingly infinitely. But let's go ahead and test it compared to the old snapshot. So we did the same thing we did in my previous video where I did tons of tests with blue ice, and I will link that down in the description. Pretty much I'm going to line an item with this ender chest or this chest here, and then we're going to push it with the slime block here, and we're going to see how far it goes. So it should be interesting to see how much they changed it. Okay, looks pretty similar. I'm going to count this up and see how far it is. Now I just measured it, and in the previous snapshot the item went 48 meters, and in this snapshot the item only went 32 meters. So yeah, it's pretty significant decrease in the slipperiness of this ice. What you guys are probably really wondering is how far do boats go now? So let's go ahead and push a boat and let's see if it even stays on my test track. It seems to be slowing down. Yeah, it's definitely slowing down. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and see how far it went, and I'll compare it to the previous test that we did. So in previous testing, the boat would pretty much almost go infinite amount of distance on the blue ice without stopping, and we also noticed that the packed ice was allowing the boat to go 50 meters. So I went ahead and measured this one, and this goes 90 meters, so almost double what packed ice is. So it's still pretty good, but just not as crazy as it was before. So let's see how crazy it is getting inside of a boat with a player and moving forward. I'm aligned on 0-0, so I should be correctly straight. It seems pretty decent, but yeah, you definitely don't have the craziness as you were seeing before. They also change the particle effects that go from the outside edges of the prismarine in towards the center for the conduit. And it's this little symbol, the same kind of symbol we see for the effect of the conduit power. Like a little circle with a kind of orangish dot. And this kind of represents like the heart of the sea with like the nautilus shell in the center of it. But before it was like a little orangish yellow zigzag. It changes so that the turtle shell helmet will no longer give you particle effects when you're wearing it as a helmet. So I'm still getting the water breathing effect, but as you can see, there is no particles swimming around my head. I'm really glad they fixed this. It's something I really was wanting them to change. And now it's really nice because it's such a useful item. People are more likely to use it if they don't have to have the stinking particles blocking all their view all the time. It now made it that the potion of Turtle Master will have a resistance of 4. This means if you would drink it and be in survival, withers are able to damage you. Before, it was impossible for withers to kill you or any mob pretty much, but now with the resistance of 4, it's pretty tanky-like because it's going to give you a lot of resistance, but you're still capable of dying, unlike before when it was impossible to die. Although it was fun to have a resistance 6 potion for the player in survival, pretty much making him impossible to be killed. I don't think it was realistic to have this type of potion in survival because it'd make pretty much every single mob and every way to get damage just obsolete. Instead, they optimized spawn position finding code, so I'm guessing they're talking about the world spawn point maybe. And this also means that there is these grass tags. So if you look at the grass blocks, we see that top right they have a new tag which says valid spawn. I don't know, when you join a new world and they put you on a block, maybe they're looking for a valid spawn. They added a new custom world type, so if we just go through here, we can see the normal ones, and they got one called buffed. So when you go into customizations, you can see you can choose a very specific type of terrain or biome that you want to have in this world, so just one type. So if I could just choose one of these, and it will generate that. It even has options to choose some really weird ones, like for the end dimension. There's even some options for that, so you can have the world generate such as the end, and then you can choose if you want to have it like be like the end dimension generation, where it's like islands, or you want to have it be like the overworld. Let's try the end dimension with a, let's try flower plains, yeah. And then let's create the world and see exactly what it looks like. You can see, yeah, we're getting all these biomes, which you chose, which was the flower plains, and we are getting them in the generation of the end. So pretty much like the end islands, you can see like how they have edges and they're carved out. A little bit laggy, I'm guessing, because chunks are trying to generate. Also got mobs trying to spawn it. And maybe looks like mine shafts are trying to generate here as well. Oh my goodness, this is so awesome. You know, for the longest time, I always wanted like a variation of Sky Grid, but was islands. And this is like exactly what I want. This is like the coolest way to play like maybe technical Minecraft. You could play like, instead of playing like Skyblock, you could play like in this situation. I only wish you could choose this type of terrain generation, but for a normal world. So having like all the normal different types of biomes and just having them like the end so that people have to like transition between islands and have farms in different islands. I think that'd be really cool. So now let's try the end biomes, but with the overworld generation. So it should be a really big flat area. Not exactly what I was expecting. I was expecting at least maybe endstone. Oh, but look over here. Here's one of the random gateway portals. there's water here too. Oh, that's just kind of strange. It fixed a lot of stuff, including bubble columns no longer being able to be pushed by a piston. So if I go ahead and power this piston, you'll see that it won't be able to move this bubble column. Instead, it will just break it, and then this water source over here will eventually deplete. That means that really cool flying machine that I made that would move bubble water columns is no longer going to work, but you can still move water just by having it inside of a waterlogged block, such as this. said they fixed it so that you can no longer force waterlogged blocks not to spread their water. So pretty much a trick I showed earlier where you could hurry switch out a block and then the water underneath here wouldn't flow. They fixed it so that sprinting underneath the water in creative will no longer put you in the swimming mode, which was really annoying. I'm glad they fixed this. You can now pick block the center of kelps as well as the tall seagrass. Now they said they fixed it so that now you can place water on top of mangrove blocks and it will create a bubble column. Now before we place water on top of it, a little bit afterwards it would create a tick and then the mangrove block would destroy the water source above it. Now this doesn't occur, but it doesn't automatically make a water bubble source above it either, or water column. So if I come in here and I swap out this block, it'll update the mangrove block, which will allow it to turn into one of the bubble columns. It looks like they reorganized the eggs. Now they are in alphabetical order. So before, the tropical fish were at the very, very end of it. It said they fixed the hitboxes for the salmon as well as the tropical fish when they're on land. I'm not sure if that's quite a fix. This one looks a lot better, but this one still looks a bit off. They also fixed it, so now dispensers will work with tropical fish in buckets. So if we go ahead and power this, you can see it drops off the water as well as the fish. And yep, we can keep powering it. We can drop off all the fish in this area. Really cool. Of course, having empty buckets in there will have a probability of pulling the water source back again. Now when waterlogged blocks get frozen by a natural occurrence, they will no longer delete the block inside them. They fixed it so that sponges will now, once again, destroy water that's moving, but they also removed it so sponges cannot destroy lava. They fixed it now so lava that is over top of water will create stone. In the previous snapshot, that was broken. They also fixed the weird color of lava that we were seeing down inside of the caves. So previously, a drow could drop one from his loot table as well as one that's holding in hand. Now they have fixed that, so it will only drop one trident. Here's a really, really rare drow. This is one that's holding a trident in the right hand and a nautilus shell in the left hand, which is now possible. A bunch of small tweaks and bug fixes, which will all get us closer to the 1.13 release date for the aquatic update. So if you guys have anything you want me guys to check out in the snapshot, tell me down in the comments. If you found this interesting, show me with a like and share it with others. And don't forget, if you want to see more snapshot reviews as well as 1.13 farms, subscribe and don't forget the bell button. Bye-bye!